Hi friends, welcome back to Featherfoot. Today's topic is the body language of your bird. So you know, as the topic states that you know, body language of the bird. Why body language of your bird is necessary for you as a bird keeper is important to understand. Let me give my own example. Few years back, when I started keeping birds. I was like any other bird keeper. Like I need to hand tame my birds, and you know, and I want them to be as my pet, and they wanted me, vice versa. Okay, so as you can see here, from then onwards, I started hand taming birds. I have hand tamed right from finches till the big birds. So presently I am taming these birds, and the bird which you can see here started talking now. So the Lutino cocktail, so as you people know that his name is Wings, and he started speaking few words. So as a bird keeper, my keen interest on birds make me to take them when they are too young, something like between 13 to 15 days old. So I'll be taking them out from the nest box, and I'll be hand feeding them, and and I'll start taming them. Okay, so guys, this is about my birds, Wings, Olives, and this is 30 years old male Lutino, and his name is Karna. Okay, since you can see him is too active, and if you just leave him, he just start running around all the places. So he's that active, and I didn't feel like giving him to anyone. So when compared to these two flocks, he is much more active when compared to the age when these two were around 30 days old. They were not that active as this flock is. So I thought, okay, let me train even better than him. Okay. Let's go into depth about their sign language and their body language. For example, if they are standing in the single leg, which means they are okay. Suppose if they are standing on the perch with two eggs with fully puffed feathers, making their feathers big, especially with their in their neck region and their wings region, which means they are actually relaxing. Okay, so this is the types of body language what our flocks possess, but only on the detailed observation you will be coming to know what exactly your bird is trying to say with their body language. Okay, so and when they are sitting on the perch or standing on the perch, holding the perch tightly, and and if they are keeping their head back or under the feathers, which means they are sleeping. And for example, see now you can see the Wings. So he is trying to come towards me, which means like he's trying to say me that, see, you can see here, as soon as I keep my hand here, he is like coming closer to my hand, which means he's trying to tell me that just open the door so that I come outside and I can play with you. Okay, so you can see here, so he is like coming very closer to me, and he'll be doing all the nonsense stuff. Okay, so and when it comes to this flock, what I have observed within these 20 days, I took him when he was 10 days old out of from the nest box, and I started hand feeding him. He is just 30 days old, guys, believe it or not. He just flap his wings as soon as he see me. He just flap his wings to the ground, which means he is very eager to me to take him. So anything which flap the wings, okay, as soon as if a bird sees you, so they just flap the wings to the ground, which means they are ready to come to you, which means you need to take them right away. And having said that, they'll be staring at you, not exactly seeing you, they'll be staring at you, which means like they are ready to do some mischievous work. Like or any nonsense work, like pulling the food tray or tearing some papers and doing all this mischievous work. Okay, So this is how we need to know our flocks. And you know, when they come very closer to you and this, when they start biting your legs, or you know, when they come and stand on your legs, once again that means that take me through your hands. So that is how we need to understand our flocks. So there are many other explanation given by our experts as well. So see, I just kept my hand and he's like ready to come on me. So this is how, you know, okay, this is how we know we need to, you know, understand our flocks. One might ask me why this body language is really necessary for us to understand. Guys, why I'm doing this as a particular topic is because if you understand their behavior and their characters, and they, if you get their tones and pictures accordingly, then it will be very easy for them, for you to tame them accordingly, irrespective of, you know, if you're training, if you're giving some if you're training only specially with the tricks part, or if they are, if you're making them to talk, or if they have, if you're making them to make them, or like if you're playing some games with them. So this body language should be synchronized with you and your bird, so that you know it will be really good for you as a bird keeper, and it will listen to you very actively. There are few other notes which has given by the experts. So let me read it for you guys, so that even if you are facing the same situation, then which is really, it will be easy for you to catch their pitch accordingly. Okay, if they are telling the sheikh, I am really ready to do something new which I am not doing this many days, like if they are shaking their feathers, or especially with their tail, I have observed with my small flock somewhere there he just often try to shake his tail, which means like every time what I have observed in this flock is like when he, every time he shake his tail, especially with the tail feathers, he just explore new places within the place where he stays. This is what I have observed, and I thought, okay, let me share with you all as well. The main thing to understand understand the body language of your flocks is spend more time with them. For an average, see, if you are busy with your schedule, yes, I do, even I do as a professional, even I spend minimal time with my flocks, provided which I pay my much attention when I am with them. Okay, I try to concentrate on them maximum with the limited time what I spend with them. So for example, as I was mentioning you people, like standing on the foot, like as I was mentioning you, standing on the foot, which I have already told, there are other things like coming closer to you, and they just bend their head towards you, which means like they are like totally in love with you guys, and no matter what happens, then they just don't leave you and go. Okay, so these are the few sign languages which as a bird keeper you need to understand, especially when you're taming the birds. Okay, taming can happen in two possible ways. You need to understand and to know at what time birds listen to you. For example, generally in my few years of experience, bird will grasp whatever you say or whatever you command in the two timings, in the two timings in a day, something like morning, around in the morning or in the late afternoon. So around 6:30 to 7:30 in the morning, and somewhere around 4 o'clock to 5:30 in the late evening. Okay, afternoon, yes, it will be in that moody mindset, so that it might not listen as much active as it will listen to in the morning or in the evening. Try to spend maximum time during these times, like morning by 6:30 to 7:30, or late evening by 4:30, or by 4 to 5:30. Okay, so this is the time where you, I suggest you to spend with your flock when you are, you know, hand taming them, or you know, when you are trying them to teach some tricks, or making them talk, or you know, taking them for a free flight. Okay, guys, this is about today's you know, small topic called bird's body language. This is very important, and you know, as long as you are not spending much time on your flocks, then it will be really difficult for you to, you know, grab certain things and understand and synchronize with them. So you know, if you see, for example, you might think that he is just eating, but when I give my attention, he likes to play with me every time. Like for example, I just give an example of everyday thing what happens. I come in the late evening by 7:30, 8 o'clock, back home from my workplace, and I call his name Wings. Even by 7:30 start shouting, and he never leaves me until unless I come, sanitize myself and take him out, play with him for a while, and then again I'll leave back to the cage. So this is how the bonding with me and my flock is. So by seeing this bird, even the olive started, you know, the same things. I spend maximum time in taming this guy, but when it comes to taming of olives, the gray cocktail, I have spent very minimal time. Why? Because when I started teaching him, he just observed certain things, and he started, you know, grasping on his phone. These are, you know, when it's like difficult to, you know, tame one bird, but very easy to tame the second bird, because when I'm doing certain things with him, and the other bird will start observing the same, and it will be really easy for you, so that you no need to start from the scratch. So that is how I started taming you know, the olives as well. And having said that, this guy is entirely different from these two. He is like very, very active flock, and you know, he started listening to me, and even now he identify who will be, you know, feeding them, feeding the him in the morning, and who will be feeding in the afternoon. He started, observing the comments what I give, or you know, my family people give. So that's how active he will be, and you know, he started, you know, grasping the comments whatever we give him. Okay, so guys, this is about today's topic. Hope you have certain bit of knowledge about the bird's body language. If you have any queries related to the hand taming process, you can anytime give me a call, or you can text me to any of my social media pages like Facebook, Insta, Twitter, Telegram, etc. You know, this is Chetan signing off from Brotherhood. Thank you. Thank you once again. Tell me pretty lies. Look me in the face. Tell me that you love me, even if it's fake.